Greetings, Planeswalkers. Got a special deck for you this evening. My daily is attack with 45 creatures, and this card specializes in just that. Called Rousing the Rabble, it is a tricolor deck, white, green, and red. So let's start off with the two mana cards, Citizen's Crowbar. As this card enters the battlefield, we create a 1/1 green and white citizen creature token. We attach Citizen Crowbar to it. Has the option to sacrifice the crowbar and destroy an artifact or an enchantment. Nurturing Presence, another enchantment aura. Whenever a creature enters the battlefield under your control, this creature gets +1/+1 until the end of turn. When Nurturing Presence enters the battlefield, we create a white 1/1 spirit creature token with flying. I think you might be able to see where this is going. Sunset Revelry, this is a pretty nice card. You can typically wait a turn or two before using it. If your opponent has a fast deck, you'll be down a life or two and down a creature or two. And get four life, create two creature tokens, and draw a card. Join the Dance, card with flashback. We create 2/1 white human creature tokens. And Courier's Briefcase, we can create a 1/1 green and white citizen creature token or sacrifice it to add one mana of any color. If we have five different colors of mana, we can sacrifice Courier's Briefcase, draw three cards. The three mana cards, Halo Fountain, this is a pretty interesting card. Untap a tapped creature for one white mana. Create a 1/1 green and white citizen creature token. Two white mana. Untap two tapped creatures we control, draw a card, and then pay five white. Untap 15 tapped creatures you control, win the game. Adeline, Resplendent, Cathar. Obviously, we're creating tokens as we attack with this creature, and its power is equal to the number of creatures we control. Battle for Braedegard. You can conceivably win the game by causing your opponents to quit with this card. If you've used some of these cheaper cards, get some of these human tokens out, spirits, citizens, etc. White human soldier creature. So we've got at least five or six different tokens, if I'm not mistaken, in this deck. Maybe more. I'd have to look. But if we've got one of each out, by the end, we're going to double our creature tokens. Obviously, this deck is a little susceptible to the Destroy All Creatures cards, Meat Hook Massacre, and some of the others. But it's a pretty fast deck, and if we can get enough creatures out, it can be pretty overwhelming. Torin's Fist of Angels. When we cast a creature spell, we create a 1/1 green and white human creature soldier token. Cabaretti Charm. We've got three options with this tricolor card. We can deal damage equal to the number of creatures we control to target creature or planeswalker. Obviously useful. Creatures we control get +1/+1, get trample. Also good with a lot of creatures, or we can create more creatures. And this one, devastating to a conventional creature deck. Doesn't do any damage to our creatures, and three damage to each non-token creature. Hallowed Haunting, if we can get some of these enchantments out. There are a few. Nurturing Presence, of course. Battle for Braedegard. We get spirit tokens. Starnheim Unleashed. We get 4/4 Angel Warrior tokens, which also works with Battle for Braedegard. And Darling of the Masses, our citizens get +1/+0. When she attacks, we get another 1/1 white and green citizen creature token. This is the key card. Rabble Rousing, the deck is named after this. Hideaway 5, which is when this permanent enters the battlefield. Look at the top five cards of your library. Exile one face down, then put the rest on the bottom in a random order. Whenever you attack with one or more creatures, create that many 1/1 green and white citizen creature tokens. Then if you control 10 or more creatures, you may play the exiled card without paying its mana cost. Imagine you have exiled this card or even this card. As we attack with, or if we control 10 or more creatures, we can pay that without mana cost, causing 3 damage to every creature our opponent has, no damage to any of ours, etc. Very interesting card, very cool card. Rakish Revelers, we've got the option to exile this card for 2 and get one of the colors of mana that we might need at the time, a mountain, a forest, or a plain, and then obviously when this card enters the battlefield, we create a white and green creature, citizen creature token. We've got multicolored lands in here. I think I'd need to expand the lands in this deck, truthfully. It is, it's got, you know, fairly a good number of multicolor lands, but, you know, this one, in the case of Sokinzan Crucible Defiance, we can create more spirit creature tokens with haste. But there's so many versatile lands now that have options like this. One of every color from the neon set. And then we have these kind of evolving wild cards, but a little bit narrower focus when we're looking for specifics. In this case, mountain, forest, or plains. And we get one life. And it's a common. So nice card there. Jetmir's Garden. We've got cycling in this card, which is a pretty old mechanic in Magic. It's nice to see him bringing it back because it can be useful. In this case, we've got a card that can generate 3 colors of mana. So this deck is fairly fast. I think it's pretty obvious to see how it works. Rabble Rousing, you can generate a fair number of creatures, and I have in games that I've played without Hallowed Haunting, without Rabble Rousing, and just generating so many tokens and then getting a Battle for Bredegarde out, and once they double, unless your opponent has something to answer that with, you could just win by him or her conceding. So it's a fun deck to play. I will say I was playing a very solid deck of mine when I came across a deck like this my opponent had, and very intriguing. He just destroyed me. I mean, it was not even fair had I continued, and we had been playing for a few turns, and I had a fair number of cards out, but yeah, it wasn't even worth it to go on. It was so overwhelming. So give it a try. Tell me what you think. Please, please, please subscribe to my channel. You're going to be getting a deck a day minimum for a month. And I while they're not all the best decks, they're certainly interesting. They've got cool themes. Some of them are really good. And I've got 3 now, my top 3 decks I haven't even shown yet. And literally one of those decks has taken me all the way up in the ranked fights to above platinum or diamond, I think it is diamond. Anyway, so please comment if you got some suggestions for this deck. If you've got a deck like this, tell me how yours plays. I really appreciate a subscribe and a like. Again, have fun gaming, and this is the Gamesman saying see you later.